Lecturer and author Timothy Good once detailed an incident involving the President of the United States, nuclear weapons, and alien interceptors working for an intergalactic allegiance who were showing concerns about activity on the Earth. They warned us to stop the nuclear program or face annihilation. The stage was the U.S. Air Force Base somewhere in New Mexico. The president was Eisenhower, and the interceptor he was meeting, who was not of this earth, went by the name Valiant Thor. Is it possible there are an actual group of extraterrestrials that oversee everything on planet Earth? As long as we remember, our species here on planet Earth have credited our origins to God or gods who arrived here and created the heavens and the earth. Imagine if this biblical passage about Genesis of humanity was a direct reference to our arrival, the terraforming of this planet, and the creation of an atmosphere on a planet that was apparently without form and void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep, and the Spirit of God moved upon the face of the waters. It isn't easy to set a meet with the most powerful man on earth, so how was this done in the 1950s by a guy who apparently came out of nowhere? Telepathy, it seems, was the chosen form of communication by a visitor who could access human thought on an individual level up to large groups and alter thought structure that would otherwise be opposing decisions. Through this method, Thor stood out, and with his guidance, meeting the president on three occasions, he built up a trust that would help guide not only American thinking at a critical time in the arms race, but also spread an influence to the entire globe. There are now numerous former government employees from all over the world coming forward to tell their knowledge about aliens visiting the Earth. But is there any evidence to support these astounding claims? After World War II, we made key quantum leaps forward in technology. We suddenly got good at a lot of things like flying or making weapons that could split the atmosphere, creating ozone problems, and possibly even responsible for the South Atlantic anomaly, which is leaking radiation into the Earth from the Van Allen Belt even to this day. Why was that? Why did we make quantum leaps in a short space of time? This was a critical time. Could it be that we uncovered ancient secrets that the German scientists had accumulated through the 1930s? Would a highly advanced race of beings give the human race access to technology that sends us forward in our understanding of everything? They would obviously give us a little drip at a time, right? But why would they do this? What are we to them? And could the gift of knowledge lead to misuse by the novice in charge of something brand new? We could misunderstand a technology that was ancient to the Earth, and an intervention may have occurred to not repeat an event already described in ancient Hindu scripture as already having happened on the Earth. Well, what if we were to tell you that this did actually happen, and the President of the United States wanted to tell the public that an outside force was engaging in human activities? Wait till you hear this. In 1957 in Virginia, an event took place that sounds like it's straight out of a science fiction book. A craft landed in a field, and a man, who looked human in every way, got out and asked two armed police officers to take him to their leader. He calmed the officers with a thought transference, and they drove him straight to Washington to rendezvous with the leader of the free world. This was the arrival of Valiant Thor. Thor stated that he was sent here by the High Council on behalf of the intergalactic community. He was one of the finest leaders of a nearby planet and was operating under the direction of the Central Control, and who had been chosen to make the Earth contact, as well as direct the project to warn of the development of nuclear bombs on our planet, which had become an interstellar concern. He had contact in influencing the decision makers in America, and gently warned that what we were doing in developing weapons would eventually end in the annihilation of the human race. This was a sort of crossroads, because if we had ignored Thor's warning, we may have been forced into change by an intergalactic community. Photographs have surfaced of Thor meeting with top officials, and Dr. Frank Stranges, the author of Stranger at the Pentagon, was a federal marshal and chaplain who had top secret security clearance at the Pentagon. This account was backed up by Harley Byrd, the nephew of Admiral Richard E. Byrd, who worked for the Department of Defense from 1957 to 1963, and was assigned to Project Blue Book, investigating with a secret military program with a purpose of documenting visitors in the sky. Even members of President Eisenhower's family, including his great-granddaughter Laura Eisenhower, insist the story is true. The president was stopped in his tracks before he tried to announce the story to the United Nations. Can you imagine what the world would be like today if he had not been opposed? Eisenhower, who was president from 1953 to 1961, and is known to have had a strong belief in life on other planets, formed from ideas and encounters developed from the front line of the technological process. The former five-star general in the United States Army, who commanded the Allied forces in Europe during the Second World War, was also keen on pushing the U.S. space program. His meeting with Valiant Thor is said to have taken place while officials were told that he was on vacation in Palm Springs, California, in February 1954. According to classified documents released by the Ministry of Defense in 2010, Winston Churchill may have ordered a UFO sighting to be kept secret. The UFO was seen over the east coast of England by an RAF reconnaissance plane returning from a mission in France or Germany towards the end of the war. Churchill is said to have discussed how to deal with UFO sightings with Eisenhower, and this same story was told to the late Phil Schneider, a geologist and engineer who had a level 1 security clearance in secret government projects. He helped build underground military bases and worked at the famed Area 51 base. Schneider said he also met Thor, and he had left Earth with him in the 1950s in a spacecraft not built on this planet. He spent 17 years working on government black projects. With a level 1 security clearance, Phil worked at Area 51, S4, and Los Alamos. He is one of only three survivors from the infamous alien-human war at Dulce, New Mexico, and the Los Alamos underground area in August of 1979. Over 60 government workers and agents were killed during these confrontations, and after 13 attempts on his life, Phil Schneider was found dead in his apartment on January 17, 1996. He had apparently been dead for several days and reportedly had a rubber hose wrapped 3 times around his neck. Officially, suicide is now stated as the cause of death, but the medical examiner took blood and urine samples at the autopsy but refused to analyze them, saying that the Clackamas County Coroner's Office would not waste their money on a suicide. Samples were kept for 12 months, and when interested parties asked for these samples to be sent to an independent lab 11 months later, they were missing and presumed destroyed. Schneider had missing fingers on his left hand and limited motion in his shoulder, and this made it physically impossible for him to have had the rubber hose in his left hand with missing fingers, and then wrapped the hose 3 times around his own neck with shoulders that had limited motion. In order to end up where his body was, he would have had to sit on the edge of his bed, wrap the hose around his neck slowly, and painfully strangle himself to death and fall headfirst into a wheelchair. Philip was an expert in chemicals and his own medical needs. He had multiple pills at hand that could have ended his life quickly and painlessly. He also had a gun that he borrowed to protect himself and could have ended his life with one shot. Phil's shocking revelations about the U.S. government and aliens was the most likely cause of his death.